Here, I have the M1 MacBook Pro, and I love this thing. I love the new Apple Silicon. So if you're rocking an M1 or M2 Apple device, or maybe M3 by the time you watch this video, I don't know, you're gonna have a bit of trouble, at least now, as of 2023, running Windows on your Mac. And not a ton of trouble. It just won't be free. Now you might be wondering why. Let me tell you real quick. 30-second overview of why you can't run Windows. I'm sorry. Apple used to use Intel processors, their CPU. But then they said, no, we can do this better. And now they're using their own chips called Apple M1 and now the M2. Now this is actually great, except for one reason. They're using what's called an ARM architecture. ARM, just like this. You don't need to know a lot about this, except that it's very different from what they used to do and what everyone else pretty much does. You see, people who use Intel or AMD CPUs right now on most laptops and most PCs, not all, because Intel and AMD do make ARM processors, but most of the time they're using x64, or if they're only 32-bit, it'll be x86. Now x64, all you have to know about that is that's the architecture of most of our CPUs, so when the creators of Windows make new versions of Windows, they make it for specific CPUs, the x64 CPU. So what that means is you have to find a version of Windows 11 that can run not on a 64-bit CPU, but on a ARM-based CPU. Does Windows have that? Yes, they do, but it's not easy to get. And that's kind of the point of this video. How do we get a Windows ARM version on this MacBook so we can run Windows 11? It's simple, but not free. Let me show you. Now, I did try to figure this out for a bit just to make sure I wasn't missing anything. But the solution will be using a software called Parallels. Now, Parallels is a Type 2 hypervisor you can use on your Mac. It's one of the most popular. They only build it for the Mac, so it's amazing. And they make it almost stupid easy to run Windows on your Mac. Let me show you. Now, first, just so you know, if I go to products and I go to Parallel Desktop for Mac, if I were to buy this new license, let's check it out. $75 for the standard edition. I'm not gonna go over the different editions. Just know it's gonna cost that much money if you wanna use it long term. Now, real quick, if you just wanna get some Windows on your Mac to play with it, you can do this by doing a free trial, which I'm going to do right now. I can do try now and download a free trial, which will download somewhere hidden on my my Mac. I go to find it. There it is. So let's install Parallels. They even show you like what to do. It's kind of funny. I like that little graphic. So click that. It'll install it for you. It's going to ask you for a password and stuff probably. Yep, there goes my password prompt. And we're almost there. Now, as I'm doing this, just know, this will be for only Windows 11. As we go through this course, I may introduce Windows Server, and it's not going to be easy or even possible to do this locally on your Mac. That's why I do encourage you to try at least something like Microsoft Azure in the cloud. Anyways, hey, it's complete. Now they do want you to create an account. I don't like that, but they make the rules. Now they kind of make it seem like a party. They're like, buy now, do it. Let's just continue our trial. We have 14 days. And notice here, you're free to create whatever kind of virtual machine you want, but they hit you right in the face with, hey, do you want to get Windows 11 from Microsoft? Yes, I do. Click that, continue, and it's just going to do this for you. Because let me tell you, I spent some time trying to find the Windows 11 for ARM ISO. It's possible, not easy. Not something I would want to walk you through in a video. Here, they just like, I mean, coffee break. Take a little coffee break, let this do its thing. Validating, almost there, I think. Ah, it's starting, here we go. And what it's actually doing, which is pretty cool, is it's going through kind of an unattended installation, meaning it's just gonna install it for you at the same time. So it's setting up, it's doing its thing. I haven't had to click anything. That's the point. It's on autopilot. It's like I'm driving my Tesla, except safer. Ah, finally, I think. And the updates hit us. Ah, there we go. It even shared my same desktop. That's really, really strange. But there you have it. Getting access to Windows 11 through Mac Parallels. It took a minute and I went a little bit insane, but this is the best way to do it for M1 and M2 Mac-based machines, unless you want to go for the Azure cloud. That's about it. I'll see you in the next episode.
Oh, you're still here? If you want to see more great IT courses just like this one, go to academy.networkchuck.com. Link in the description.